Good, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Freethinking the Culture podcast. Again, but, hey, you see the title, you know why we're here, and it's a subject that needs to be talked about as far as with Kanye West. Now, I know all the basics, and you know all the basics on what he said, the anti-Semitism, the different things that really triggered people to cancel Kanye West. Now, I'm going to ask you right off the bat, do you think Kanye West deserves the cancellation he's getting right now? That's just my first question straight out the gate. Look, guns blazing, I'm not even wasting your time. The reason why I ask these certain questions going into it, because I feel like, not that it's unwarranted. Let me first say this. We've all known Kanye West to be Kanye West. Now, what does that mean? Kanye West is a musical genius. Great. We understand that point. But how much is too much and how far is gone too far? Now, the main point that is being brought up was, and it's mainly from my people, I'm speaking from a black perspective. Y'all didn't cancel Kanye West when Kanye West said the thing about slavery. That should not be your main fighting point on that. I understand what you're going for, but that shouldn't be your main fighting point. The reason I say that is because we can't keep linking everything to that. When I say free think, for me, what does that mean for me? It means let me think beyond what Kanye is presenting. Now, do you think Kanye has a different plan? I don't know. I can't say he do. I can't say he don't. I'm not Kanye West. But what I can say for me, I can say that I've watched a lot. I've seen a lot of cancellations. Some were warranted and many weren't. However, when I now look at this, I start to question society and censorship. And don't, again, I am not agreeing with Kanye and I'm not disagreeing with Kanye. I'm right in the middle and I'm trying to add a perspective of outside looking in. There's been a lot of push to censor people and get them kicked off of social media. And it's not just Kanye West. It started with, like, the really big push lately was Andrew Tate. Now, Andrew Tate says some crazy things, but when have we not seen some crazy things on social media, right? So when I see something like a Kanye West, I remember back when they were pushing Nicki Minaj to get her pushed off. There was a lot of pushback for these certain artists that had something to say. And it may have not been in the industry's best interest to keep these people on board. They had to sun them a little bit to say, let me sit you down just to teach you a lesson, right? And I see the push. I see how things are going. But I grow concerned about how we as the general population will be affected by that later on, right? Because when we start to do it from the higher up, what do they say? Shit rolls downhill, correct? So when we start seeing things being pushed from up top and it starts trickling down to, you know, to us, you know, I won't call us regular folk, because we all got our thing. But you know what I mean. When things start getting pushed down like that, you know it's only going to be worse for us. There's somebody else that would have been pushed off social media eventually had he lived long enough, and that would have been Kevin Samuels. Now, Kevin Samuels was on the rise, and I felt like if Kevin Samuels would have lived just another year, I felt like eventually social media would have kicked him off as well. So now I start to question, okay, what is beyond the veil of what's being presented to us? It's not the fact that, again, I don't agree with everything Kanye West says, which I don't disagree with everything Kanye West says. I don't. But here's the great thing about us free thinking and being individuals. We can have different opinions, and there's a certain way to get it across. But let's not be disrespectful towards one another, because what I'm starting to see, especially from my community, which I really, really hate for us, because I really, really want something really different for the black community. And I'm speaking for me, myself. I really want a unified front to where we can just pull the cousins to the side. You know, we got them cousins or them brothers or them sisters or them crazy mamas or them daddies. We just want to pull you to the side and say, come, can I please talk to you away from the general population? Because I don't want to have this discussion with you out in public. What I'm really getting tired of these discussions being had out in public, and it's for like the display for the world to see. And it always makes it look like, see, they can't ever get it together. They always fight. See how they do? But see, now the bigger issue is bringing it back to what you guys were saying about, well, y'all didn't cancel him when it was the thing, when he said it about slavery being a choice. I understand what Black people were saying about that. Now, granted, I don't want that to be a main talking point, but I get it. Where was the outrage from media with that then? That's a huge issue. But see, then Black people need to pay attention, in my opinion, to the media and how we're treated, because this is like a public lashing almost. In my opinion, the way that they punish these artists by deplatforming them, basically taking away their, well, he's going to be fine. Let me not act like his lifestyle is just going to change dramatically, because they said that he's not a billionaire anymore. Oh, wow. 400 million. I want 400 million. I think I'll be perfectly fine on my ranch in Colorado somewhere, just minding my business. I will just go grow some weed and make a business out of that. They still go buy it. They go smoke that yay. It don't matter. But the thing is, when is enough enough for censorship? Where do we go from here? But then let's move beyond Kanye West and what he's presenting. What is the master plan for Kanye West? The self-worth of it all. Now, let's give Kanye West the benefit of the doubt and say that he's this mad scientist, this mad genius, and he's purposely severing ties with all these different companies to, A, start his own business, start his own empire, you know, that way without having ties to Balenciaga, Gap, Adidas, all these the other different brands that he had these ties to. Let's say he did that on purpose to just get this away from all of that. That would be brilliant. But at what cost did you do that? Because then it comes the thing of self-sacrifice for the self-worth part aspect of it. How much are you willing to sacrifice for your place in history to be able to say, I did it my way? Because you can't do things your way when you're tied to different empires of somebody else's. You're building somebody else's empire. If you're not an entrepreneur, you are clocking in, clocking out, and you're building somebody else's business up. So when you try to go on your own journey away from all of that, trying to discover like, okay, what do I fit in with this? And you start to do your own thing. You have to be disconnected from a lot of that, because once you start running your own business, you don't have time for anybody else's stuff. That's my opinion. Okay. And I'm very interested to know, just for you to think, do you think that that's the motive beyond Kanye's madness? What is he up to? Somebody mentioned to me just yesterday, I believe, they were saying that Kanye is supposed to be trying to start his own little small city. That would be beautiful if he did. But at what cost? Are people going to want to move there? Of course, the Kanye fanatics are going to move there. But are you going to have actual productive people that are there for the right reasons? There's a way to move throughout society. I agree. And sometimes you're going to have to shake up things a lot. And I think Kanye, which is why I titled this the Kanye Effect, I feel the way that he's moving things is causing some type of shift. It's causing some type of change. I don't know. You let me know what you think. But self-worth, true love for yourself, and really saying, I don't want to be controlled by people anymore. I want to do something on my own. That's a hard path to take. And a lot of the times you're going to have to deal with that on your own. Realistically, a lot of that path you're going to be with on your own. That's just facts. People say that they're independent and people say that they're strong, but you're only as strong as your next challenge. You really are. You never know. You really, really never know how strong you are until all the odds are against you. And right now, I feel like Kanye West in this moment, you may not agree, but Kanye West in this moment, this is the defining moment for Kanye West. Either put up or shut up, because right now, if you don't pull the rabbit out the hat to make this work, you will only be able to rely on your past efforts, because the way that you sever ties with a lot of America, it's going to damage him. It's going to damage his social credit. And I feel like that's where we're headed now, because in the court of public opinion for society, that's literally what it is. You're not good enough to be with us, so we're going to cast you out of society, right? If you've ever watched Black Mirror, and they had this episode where it was dealing with like social credit, and they've been hinting about that for a while, with it being like a social credit type of thing. And I've been kind of concerned with that, because it's like, we know different cultures of people don't like other different cultures of people. What does that say about me walking the streets and somebody's able to pull out their phone and basically say, I rate him 1 star because I don't like the way he looks, or I don't like him because he's black. I don't like her because she's a Karen. I don't like this person because they serve tacos. I don't like this person because they eat hot Indian food. It's that I'm scared of within society. And to me, this push that we're doing, again, with Nicki Minaj, let's go back even further. Let me not even do the current artists. Michael Jackson, Prince. Those two people experienced that same type of outcasting in society. And luckily, they were able to bounce back from it. They had to work extra super hard just to get that notoriety back. But the thing is, look how quickly society turned against them by a media narrative. And now I'm concerned with the media, because here's the main topic that a lot of people are calling anti-Semitism and things like that. A lot of points that Kanye made about the Jewish control in the media. What was so wrong with saying the Jewish control the media? Do you control the media or not? Are you a gatekeeper of the media or not? Because if it was more to that, then let me know. But the main thing is, whenever anybody gets close to speaking about, I think, Jewish bloodlines and control and gatekeeping, it becomes this collective effort of all media to outcast this person. And I'm kind of concerned with that, because what are you hiding that is such a concern that you need to do this to these artists? And not only these artists, society in general. Now, do not get me wrong. There should be things you can and can't do on social media, but that doesn't stop them in the real world. Because in the real world, people say what they want, they do what they want, but that's not to say that it's out without consequences. Now, freedom of speech does not mean it's freedom of consequences. That's the part of the clause, the secret part of the clause that's in the invisible ink they don't tell you. They'll say, yeah, you got freedom of speech, you free, all this other thing, but the amendment, the dot, 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 but... Don't do this, don't do this, don't say this, you may offend this, don't do this, don't do this, don't do this, don't do that. I'm concerned with the fact that they are not showing society the fine print. Show me the fine print. Because I really want to know, in particular, why people get kicked off of social media, like Andrew Tate again. The different things that he was saying to me are no different than a lot of extremists in feminism. Feminism has said some very horrible things about men. A lot of things that a lot of men find offensive, but they did not deplatform these women. And that's not to attack all feminists, because I know all feminists aren't equal. Some feminists actually believe in equal treatment and equal opportunity for all on a scale that most men agree on. Yes, you should be getting paid this as long as you do equal work. Yes, you should be paid this if you had the qualifications. Yes, we actually agree with that. But then when we look into the point of construction, plumbing, sewage, all these other electricians, garbage, trash workers, all of that, city workers and all that, that's majority run by men. So then we say, okay, well, where are y'all at in these fields? STEM, Silicon Valley, majority ran by men. Where are the women in that? That's an open field. In fact, I think they give incentives for women to come and join in. So back to all of that, back to Kanye West. I'm concerned, not only for Kanye's mental health, because he suffers from bipolarism. He has his manic situations. And I think a lot of the times they play on his social, his mental disorders in order to justify getting rid of Kanye. But my point is, for my culture, for me, and I'm speaking personally for me, I don't want to be responsible for the disintegration of my culture. That's musically, that's socially, physically, mentally, anything like that. I want us to be able to have these discussions and come together and come to some type of solution without it being a kick you off the island situation. We maybe can put you over here, but not off the island. We're already low in numbers as it is. We need as many people as we can. And with that being said, that's my time on Freethinking the Culture. Again, I appreciate you guys pulling up and really just listening and taking care and really just giving this podcast a second thought. Again, you can follow me on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, And all of the different platforms, actually. But right now, you're probably listening on YouTube, Apple, Spotify mainly. But just to let you know, I thank you once again. Please leave me a review, rate the podcast, and let me know how I'm doing. Let me know what we can be able to talk about. If you enjoy the vibe, let me know that as well. And until next time, guys, take care.